There were a significant amount of changes under the Tax Cuts and Job Act, and taxpayers should be aware that anything with taxes is a one-size-fits-one situation. There are differences in how the federal government and New Jersey calculate taxable wages. Oftentimes, the difference relates to medical premiums, and to the extent that that's what the difference relates to, taxpayers in New Jersey can claim that medical premium expense on their personal tax return. Taxpayers in New Jersey can claim medical expenses to the extent they exceed 2% of their New Jersey gross income. So for a taxpayer with $100,000 of New Jersey gross income, only the medical expenses that exceed 2% or $2,000 will qualify as a medical deduction. Let's say we have a taxpayer whose medical expenses in excess of the floor are $10,000. If that taxpayer is in the 6.37% tax bracket, they would see a $637 tax savings simply by claiming that medical expense deduction. As a revenue-raising provision under the Tax Cuts and Job Act, there was changes to the meals and entertainment expense deduction. Taxpayers that previously provided meals on their premises for their convenience were entitled to 100% deduction for those meals expenses. Going forward, those deductions are going to be subject to a 50% limitation, and in 2026, those deductions will be no longer allowable and completely disallowed. New Jersey has said that they will only allow taxpayers to deduct 2017 taxes on their 2017 return, and the 2018 real estate taxes will be deductible on their 2018 return, regardless of whether or not those taxes were prepaid or not. The Tax Cuts and Job Act is going to impact them. It's impacting all taxpayers. But they should be in contact with their tax advisors to really understand what the new law is going to mean for them and if there's any possible tax planning opportunities they can be taking advantage of.